Ya Hanana, Ya Hanana, Ya Hanana. As Sidi Tariq said that all of you are being elevated. There is Sakina, there is tranquility. Allah ordered Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, صلي عليهم فإن صلاتك سكن لهم. Do salah on them. Your salah is Sakina. How much we are lucky? Wallahi, we are lucky. If you know how much Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم loves us, you will be flying. It's beyond our imagination. Every year, we have good news. We have Bashair from Al-Habib Al-Azam صلى الله عليه وسلم. Every single year in the retreat, we have something. And this year we have. Before saying the Bashair, I want to give you a small story just to know Al-Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم. There is a young man, he's like 15 years old. His name Abdul Uzza Al-Muzani. His tribe Muzayna between Mecca and Medina. His father and mother died and left him a big wealth. He's very rich, very rich. His uncle taking care of him until he's like grows up. So when the Sahaba start doing the hijrah, he start walking with them and learning from them. He became Muslim. And he wanted to really learn the Quran. He will walk like 15, 20 miles with the Sahaba, everyone coming, learn, come back. And another one coming until he learned a lot. One Sahabi told him, come with us to Hijra. He said, no, my uncle, Ammi, I want him to be with him. I want him to be Muslim. I love him. He tried, waited 3 years. Towards the end, he said, I cannot handle it anymore. He went to his uncle, he said, I am a Muslim, and I invite you. He said, look, if you become Muslim, I'll take all your wealth. Everything you have. Said, I don't care, take everything. He said, I'll take your clothes. He ripped his clothes and left him without clothes. He went walking to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He found, they call it bijad. It's a bag that they fill in it like whether soil or rice or wheat, whatever it is. It's a very coarse. It was thrown. So he cut it into two pieces and he covered himself. Went to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, why are you wearing this? Who are you? And he told him the story. He said, first, your name is Nabd Abdul Izza, Abdul Uzza. He said, your name, Ya Habibi, Abdullah Dhul Bijadain. He changed his name. He stayed with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, with Ahlul Suffa, next to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Don't leave him at all. Then Ghazwat Tabuk came. It's a few hundred miles away from Medina. He went to Rasulullah. He said, Rasulullah, make dua for me that I'll have shahada in this battle. And he asked Allah, Sayyidina Muhammad said, Ya Allah, don't let any of the kuffar get to him. He was, يعني, Ya Rasulullah, that's what and Rasulullah told him, well, if somebody fell from his horse and died, he's a shaheed. And if somebody could have fever and die, he's a shaheed. On the way back, after they got the victory, he got a fever, high fever, and he died. Sayyidina Abdullah Mas'ud read this. He said, it was a very cold night, and I was asleep in my tent, and I heard somebody digging. What's happening? I rushed to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to see Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, nobody there. I went there, I found Sayyidina Abu Bakr have a light in his hand and Sayyidina Umar next to him and Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam digging a grave by himself. I came angry. Why you allow him? Why don't you? Said, no, that's what he wanted, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after he finished, he laid down himself in the grave. He wanted the Rahamat to come to this place. And then he told them, give me Abdullah. He took him and he hugged him and he cried, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he put him in the grave and he said, Ya Allah, I love him. Ya Allah, ana radi anhum, ana pleased on him. I'm pleased with him. Let the rahmat comes to him. Sayyidina Abdullah Mas'ud, he said, that moment I wish that I was the one who died. And then they put him there and we came back. He left everything, the whole wealth that he have, everything he have for what? For his love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah said, he was awwaban yatlu al-Qur'an. He used to go to Allah that always and he used to recite Qur'an all the time. So that's a boy who became a real man next to Rasulullah sallam. And look the love that Rasulullah sallam really showed to all of us. His love to all of you is more than this. As I said, every year, Sayyidi Shaykh Yahya will say, Tarif, we need a bushra, we need good news. And this goes back to the first retreat. And in the first retreat, alhamdulillah, somebody saw Habib Ali looking at the whole retreat and like giving a barakah to it, and two people became Muslim in that retreat. It was the first sign. And every year there's something. This year now, I want everybody really to go back home with this good news. I was in Turkey, in Istanbul, and Sayyid Sheikh Yahya said, are you in Istanbul? He said, yes. He said, I just arrived. He came at Fajr time, and he was in Istanbul for only 24 hours. Said, I'm coming to see you. So I went to see him, and I said, I'm going to see Sayyid Mustafa Davis and to visit Sayyidina Abu Ayyub. So we end up visiting Sayyidina Abu Ayyub Ansari, and I asked Sayyidina Abu Ayyub, ya Sayyidina, you receive Rasulullah Sallam, we need our gift. Then time passes, we came here, came to the retreat. Somebody from Damascus saw a dream and he sent it to me, recorded his voice. He said, I came to you, rushing to you here to the US, and came to tell you that Sayyidina Abu Ayyub, no, he said, I came on the camel of Sayyidina Abu Ayyub to you, to tell you that Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, coming to you, he have a task for you from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr came, and he have a raya, a flag, and written on it, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And he said, take this one. Whoever read this, he'll become Muslim. And then I went to a place, a house, and then people from all around the world coming with food, like delegation after delegation coming, and they come to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and he will point, go inside the house. And they will come in, and they all become Muslim. Then they come out. Sayyidi Sheikh Samer Unus will be coming here in the dream. He came here, and you know, he is a man of Quran. Everybody who has become Muslim will go to Sheikh Samer to read Khatm Quran, and he became expert of Quran, and he goes to his country to establish a center of Quran. And look at this. We were in Turkey, and Sayyidina Abu Ayyub, right? We came here, news came from Sayyidina Abu Ayyub. I came here, and this is the news for all, good news for all of you, that you are getting this from Sayyidina Abu Bakr, a task from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Take this back with you to home. After, I think, Monday or Tuesday, Sheikh Samir is coming here to Allentown. It's ajeeb. He's coming to read Sahih Tirmidhi, Sahih? Nasa'i. For 1 week, he will read the whole ahadith. You know, Alam al-Barzakh, the unseen world, is very active. Very, very active. I was in Damascus, and by accident, I just opened the channel to Tareem to see Sayyidi al-Habib Umar. And when I opened it, Sheikh Yahya was there. And I recorded like a minute and a half, and I sent it to everybody. And it, I think, went all around the world. What did Habib Umar say? He was giving good news to Sheikh Yahya, congratulate him because his father became Muslim. And he told him, you will have a fatah opening, an amazing big fatah, when you go back here to the US. Today, another dream came. Another dream came. That we were in a house, said that my house, and we were reciting salawat on Rasulullah Sallam, and the whole house like going with high energy, like what you're doing here. And we're reading several books like the Dalail al-Khairat, al-Burda, and so on. And Sheikh Samir came, congratulated us all for all of this amazing thing. And then Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I'm gonna make it short, Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came, and he said, he told me that Allah Azza wa Jal, that will have a fatah. He said, fatah laka wa alayka لم يحدث من قبل أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that you'll have an opening for you and on you that never happened before. So add all of this together. This is amazing news that's coming to all of us. Wallahi, if we get this by itself, that's more than enough. Because seeing Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in a dream is haqq. There's no doubt in it. Whatever you are taking here, take it in your life. I just want to give you one gift for all of you, inshallah. Make intention now. All of us, let's make intention that two things that we will never forget Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That we love him, we'll never forget him. The second one, that we will do salah on him all the time. And Allah is generous. If you do 1 minute of Salatul Rasulullah and you forget 10 hours and you do another 1 minute, Allah will fill all the gaps. And that will be your intention. Niyyatul mu'min khayru min amalih. Your intention is better than your action. Make intention, all of you now, these two intentions. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.